Namaste everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Pooja and today I have with me once again Neha Padhya. Welcome Neha, thank you for being here on my channel with me today.
Thank you.
If you haven't watched our previous video together, I'll put the link in the description box below. You must check it out. In that video, Neha has chanted a couple of spiritual mantras for us and they're absolutely beautiful in honor of Lord Ganesha. So you must check it out if you haven't already. In this video, we are going to talk about rag chakras. I personally don't know much about rag chakras and I'm really, really looking forward to Neha explaining what it is and how we can use it in this video. And just before she starts explaining that, I'm just going to put in a little note for anyone who is still new to the concept of chakras. Chakras are energy centers that are located in the body. There are many, many chakras, and there are seven that are known to be the most prominent ones that are located along the spinal column. And in many ancient traditions, in many cultures, music and sound have been used a lot to create harmony in the body and around the body, and to create a vibrational resonance in the energy centers and around the body as well. So music has a very, very strong impact on our body, not only the physical body, but also the mental body and the emotional body. So let's hear from Neha about the rag chakras now. Over to you, Neha.
Basically, chakras have been an important part of every field. We do find chakras in yogasana. Chakras play an important part in the human body, and in the same way, chakras also hold an important position in Indian classical music. So since a very long time, Indians have been practicing this music. Not only Indian classical music is not only limited to a form of performing arts, but it does help you to heal your body. It does have positive vibrations, and there are various theories that have been evolved from Indian classical music. So rag chakra is one of such theories, and many people don't know much about it, but it is a very powerful tool of music therapy. Nowadays, people prefer to heal themselves in a natural way rather than opting for medications. And this is a very positive way which can help us to cure ourselves. Indian classical music, or for that matter, any sort of music, is definitely related to human psychology, different modes, different environment that we go through. And looking at the pandemic that is going around right now, we do need some peace in our life. We need some mental relaxation. And this is where music comes into picture. So definitely music can be used as a weapon or, a medium to heal ourselves and our mind. So now coming back to rag chakra, basically chakra is anything in a circular motion. So rag chakra is actually like a pie chart. It resembles a pie chart, and every section of this pie chart consists of a group of ragas. Every section represents different ragas, and it has been divided in such a way that every group will have its different effects on the human body. So the classification of rag chakra, or the basis of rag chakra, is actually the time zones of the day. The 24-hour clock that we follow has been divided like a pie chart, and every section comprising of 2 to 3 hours has been dedicated to a particular group of ragas. Now, for example, when we take the first section of the pie chart, which is mid-morning or early morning, that is around 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. So this is the time of the day when we just wake up and we do feel drowsy, but this is the time when you need some energy to start your day. So the ragas that are included in this group have such an effect that if you listen to these ragas, then you definitely feel an energy rush and you get a good start to your day and whatever your daily activities are. As we move forward to each and every section, it helps you to get throughout the day, and it induces different moods, and it also helps you to cope up with the environment. And it has such effects that the different parts of the day match with whatever effects the ragas are creating. And this way you can go throughout the day with this pie chart. So every segment is going to have a different effect on your body. And this can also be used as a part of music therapy. So there are certain ragas, for example, rag abhogi. So the combination of the swaras or the notes or the octaves that have been used in this segment help you to heal different sorts of diseases that are mainly connected to your intestine. If you're feeling low, you may listen to a particular segment that has been dedicated to such illnesses, or you can listen to such music that is going to help you to cure your mental illnesses. If you're feeling depression or anxiety, we do have another section that deals with it. So this is how it goes. The classification has been done as per the time zones of the day. But along with this, the classification can also be done as per the different effects that it is going to create on your body. So definitely medication and other treatments are there. But along with that, if we use this chakra as a supplementary course, it definitely helps you to get through it in a natural way. So this is a very important in today's life is what I think, because this is a natural way. And it does create some positive vibes and energy to get throughout the day. And as I said, music has been closely linked with human emotions, human psychology. So the Rag Chakra has been designed in such a way that it definitely helps you to uplift your mood. It knows what you need at what time of the day. And definitely this is how it works. So there have been evidences that people have been using this technique for a long period of time, because people have been facing the issues of depression, anxiety, and all related matters when we did not have that much of medical facilities available. So these were some natural remedies that people started to find out, and it has been passed on from generations to generations. There is not much study done in this field, but definitely it does help you.
Yeah. Thank you for sharing this, Neha. It's very insightful. It's very interesting to know. And there is no doubt that, you know, music is powerful. Sound is powerful because it's vibration at the end of the day. And music is believed to connect the physical, the emotional, and the spiritual realms. You know, like I said, to bring in harmony. And a lot of diseases occur when there is some sort of disharmony in the body, when the energy is not flowing properly through the nadis, as we know them in Ayurveda and yoga, the energy channels in the body. So I, since you've spoken about, you know, different time zones and different parts of the body, I'm very curious to hear some of these Raga, so would you be able to give us a small demo?
Definitely. So I'll be starting with the first segment of the day, as I mentioned, that whenever you wake up, you need some energy rush to start your day. So the very first segment deals with Rag Bhairav. So basically, ragas are a combination of notes or swaras. And these notes form a combination, and the rag and whatever the music or the songs or bandishes that are composed in that rag are based on the notes that are included in that group. Every raga is a combination of different notes, and the music that is composed in that raga is based on the notes which form the main part or main body of that group. So the first segment deals with Rag Bhairav and the different forms of Bhairav. And they have a very positive impact on our mind, and they help you to start your day in a positive way. So mainly this raga has been also used in the Vedic Puranas, and it is like it holds a certain sort of important place in the Vedic Puranas. So I'll be giving a short demo of rag Ahir Bhairav. So this was Rag Bhairav, and whatever ragas are included in this segment have been composed with the combination of notes that I tried to sing right now. So if we closely listen to what I recited right now. So you get those vibrations that we exactly get from the Vedic Puranas or the chanting of Omkara. The chanting of Omkara has been linked with the positive vibrations that we derive from the combination of Rag Bhairav. So wherever you find the suffix Bhairav, it indicates that this raga has to be sung in the morning. Now I'll be giving another example. So another segment that we choose is Rag Sham Kalyan. As we move throughout the day towards the afternoon or evening, we need some kind of music that will kind of lighten our mood. So every segment will try to induce a different kind of atmosphere and a different kind of mood. So Rag Bhairav had a kind of serious undertone. So now as we move towards Rag Sham Kalyan, the music will kind of change its form, and the vibrations that we are going to receive from Sham Kalyan will be of different sort.
Absolutely beautiful. It sounds very, very beautiful. And I love what you said about the first one relating to Omkar meditation. It was indeed very, very soothing. And you said serious undertone, but it was very grounding. And I feel that every time I chant Om, it's very grounding. It just immediately helps me come back to the present, center myself, and that's exactly what it did when you recited it. Thank you very, very much, Neha, and I look forward to having you again on my channel to share more of your gift and your talent. I'm sure the viewers enjoyed it. Thank you, Neha.
Definitely. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And to all the viewers, if you haven't watched my previous video with Neha yet, I'll put the link in the description box below. Please do check it out. She's a very, very talented young lady who is trained in classical singing for 14 years. And she has won many awards for it as well. And what I love is that she dedicates her time to give talks about classical Hindustani music to promote it. So keep up the good work, Neha, and viewers, do check out our previous video and stay tuned because we'll be having more videos like this coming up. So subscribe to my channel and share this video with all your friends and family if you enjoyed it. Thank you everyone for watching, and thank you, Neha, for sharing.